morning, Independents. Here are your announcements for Friday, February 18th. The following colleges will be at iChess in the Commons from 11:30 to 1 to speak with all interested students about admissions and scholarships. ETSU will be here Tuesday, March 1st. Christian Brothers University and Columbia State Community College will be here on Wednesday, March 2nd. O'More College of Design will be here Wednesday, March 16th. And Auburn University will be here Wednesday, March 16th in the Counseling Center from 9 to 10. By popular demand, the STEP team will be accepting new students. If you are interested, please mark your calendars for a meeting on Wednesday, February 23rd from 2:45 to 5. If you have any questions, please contact Mrs. Wiggins in the Counseling Center. Speaking of the STEP team, last week you got your first glimpse at what they can do. Well, we got caught up with Patrick Briscoe to find exactly what STEP team is all about.
What happened was, like, a group of kids actually came to Miss Slaughter and Miss Wiggins and were like, we need something new to reach out to the Indian Nation community. And so we thought that we would bring something different other than, like, sports or anything like that. So we decided stepping is, it's kind of a, not a dance, but kind of like a dance. It's kind of like rhythm type things. Like, it's really hard to explain. Just like patting your legs, like patting your hands, stomping your feet, like saying chants and moving, like, and staying in rhythm. That's a big part. There are team captains. Miss Slaughter and Miss Wiggins are the head honchos. We don't disagree with them. But actually, there are two boy captains and two girl captains. Me, Patrick Briscoe, Chris Hurd, Precious, and Janisa Sprawling. Y'all really should come check us out Friday. We're going to be really nice, really tight.
Yesterday was the last pep rally of the year. I'm sure we'll see plenty more of the STEP team. Now let's throw it over to Graham on sports.
Hello, IHS. Graham Sawyer here with UND Sports. Cheerleading packets are now available in the front office for pickup and completion. Cheerleading clinic is March 14th through the 16th, and cheerleading tryouts are on March 17th. Go Eagles! Now let's go to Pittman on sports.
Hello, I'm Ryan Pittman, Independence Eagle. Basketball team will have its first postseason game as they host the Hulk Land Points tomorrow, Saturday, February 19th at noon. Come out and support your Eagles. This has been Pittman on Sports. Go Eagles!
Thanks, Ryan. One of our very own Eagles soccer players has signed to the University of Indianapolis. Let's find out who it is.
The Independence girls soccer team has definitely been an experience. I've only played for 3 years on the team because I played volleyball my freshman year. But so as long as I've been with these girls, it's just been amazing to see them grow as players and as people, and it's been a wonderful experience, and I couldn't have asked for anything better because they're all such wonderful people and wonderful soccer players. What I'm going to miss about high school soccer the most probably is just being with the girls and going on our crazy retreats over the summer and working out at 6 a.m. in the mornings and just building that relationship with those girls. And I've grown really close with them, and I'm gonna miss them all so much. But this is a great opportunity for me, and I'm really, really excited. And even though it's gonna be 5 hours away in Indiana, I've got family up there, so I won't be too far away from home.
Megan was a player that you love to have every year on your team. She came in as a sophomore, opting to play volleyball her freshman year. So as a sophomore, she came in and she split time with a senior goalkeeper. By the end of the season, she was being used in pressure situations as our goalkeeper. But she also played on the field when injuries hit us and she had to play in the back. her junior and senior year, she was our starting goalkeeper and played most of the game, most every minute in goal. Her senior year, she led the team with only 15 goals allowed, or led the defense, I should say, with only 15 goals allowed and a .83 goals against average. She was the epitome of what a leader should be, as she demonstrated every day in practice and in games the high caliber that we were expecting of her play.
Megan Fee is one of the most fantastic athletes I've ever played with in my 2 years of soccer. She has made so many game-saving saves and has taken us really far this year, farthest we've ever been, I think. And it's going to be pretty bad to lose her, but she's going to go on and do better things in her college career. Love you, Megan.
Congratulations, Megan. Don't miss your chance to see the first rugby home game on Thursday, the 24th, on the football field. Girls will begin at 4:30 and play three halves of sevens rugby in honor of the rugby sevens, which new inductee as an Olympic sport in 2012. Guys will start at 5:30. Tickets are $5. Come out and support. Let's see what workout Kevin has this week.
What's up, Indy? We got some sick workouts this week. You can see, this is a 42-pound medicine ball. I'm gonna show you guys a couple of medicine ball workouts, but you might want to start at a lighter weight. The warrior. The triceratops. The figure eight. The phoenix. All right, now I'm gonna throw this ball around the world in 3 seconds. Nice. Your boy Kev will be here next week. Peace.
Wow, Kevin, that's intense. That's all for me this week. Back to you, C.
Thanks, G. There will be a prom fashion meeting February 25th. See Coach A for details. Attention all newly selected members of the National Honor Society. Please stop by and see Mr. Ragland in room D121 right after school today. The Hoop and Shout IHS fundraiser event will be held on Tuesday, March 8th at 6:30 in the gym. Don't miss the chance to see your teachers play the girls and boys basketball teams. Miss Liberty is one of the most recognized events here at IHS, and like every year, a large number of girls are trying out. So let's go to Paris Johnson, Taylor Darden, and Cameron Moore with more details on this year's Miss Liberty.
I mean, we just need all the info about Miss Liberty.
Okay. Right.
So, Miss T, what do you think about Miss Liberty?
I think Miss Liberty is an awesome opportunity for girls to come out and showcase their talent.
So what do you think about Miss Liberty?
I think it's a great opportunity for girls to demonstrate their...
We're here with Janissa Sprawling, a senior, class of 2011, woot woot. Janissa, what do you think about the Miss Liberty pageant of 2011?
What do they do, pretty dresses? They have pretty dresses?
Yeah.
Their talents.
I think for all the girls who are outgoing, should definitely try.
I'm gonna ask you, do you like the A's? I'm gonna ask you.
Oh, yeah.
You do? Okay.
Miss Liberty is a school-wide pageant for, it used to be during the coming home, but it's basically to show off the girls' talents.
Do they show any kind of like academic ability?
I think it's a good way for girls to be comfortable in their own skin and be able to show everybody like what they can do and like who they are.
I wish they did. I wish they'd add that in. Maybe they could have a writing contest on the stage.
Okay.
That'd be a nice addition.
Okay, do you have any talents?
Yeah, I can sing and I can dance and I like to act and I'm awesome.
We're here with the hosts for Miss Liberty today, Will Tucker and Brad King. How are you guys doing today?
Doing pretty good.
How about you?
It's been a good day.
Okay. Do you have any awesome talents you do particular?
I make a nay noise.
We're here to ask you, like, are you excited? Like, what? Like, tell us what you think about Miss Liberty.
I'm pretty excited. It's pretty fun. I mean, I went last year. I mean, I had a good time.
Nay.
That's all I know how to do.
A nay noise. Okay.
Yeah.
That's not really a talent.
What made y'all become hosts? Like, who made y'all?
What made y'all become like a host?
We were pretty much goofing off in class, and Miss T decided to ask us if we would like to host it.
It's really a pageant, but we're focusing more on the talent aspect.
I don't know. I mean, y'all just sitting down bored right now. I mean, I don't know how y'all can get people to come with that attitude, but I mean, you know, y'all want to spice it up just a little bit?
They'll be there.
But girls still get to dress up and get dressed up in 80s outfits and their evening gowns and just show off their awesome talents.
I have a lot of talents.
But what's your main talent?
Don't make me do that.
Well, that was Brad King and Will Tucker, the host. And this guy. Cheer.
I mean, I'm excited. I'm ready.
I'm excited. I'm very excited. So, that concludes our day. Peace out.
I just meet ya.
Thanks for that, guys. That's all for this week's announcements. Have a great weekend, IHS.